Welcome everyone, Cory here, back there, Fitness by Cory. Feet nice and wide, let's shift to the right and to the left. I decide full body workout today. I'm gonna hit the inner and outer thighs. Let's go ahead and lift up that right leg and hold and then push it back out. Jungle boogie. Got a little old school today. July. Where did June go? Heck, where did May go? Lift and hold. Get down. Like two more. One more. And take it back, side to side, shift it. We'll go right into that left leg right here. Lift and hold. Press it out. Lift and hold. There we go. Remember, toes, knees, hips, facing straight forward. Okay, if you turn the toe out, but what's gonna happen is you're just gonna feel a little more quadriceps. Nice, two more. One more. And perfect. Okay, alternating reverse lunge. Reach the arms to the ceiling. Push that knee low to the floor. And try to keep the hips facing straight forward. Keep the feet apart. Notice how good your body feels. Good, keep going. Open the arms. There we go. Good morning, Lynette. Good, we're going to alternate. So, arms go up, arms go wide, arms up. I was chilly early this morning, now I'm hot. That's what we want. Last 10 seconds. Last one. Opposite side. And perfect. Okay, grab one dumbbell, guys. Gonna be shoulders. So I want you to stand with your feet together first. Now, I'm gonna just hold the dumbbell in the center and I'm gonna take it to the outside of my hip. I'm gonna come up and make an L and back over to the opposite hip, okay? So from a side here to here, okay? So you're just making a cursive L. What is that? Do they teach that anymore? So keep that in mind. Your arms are nice and long in front of you. So hold that. You got that down. You're going to do that side lunge, okay, with that cursive L. So start off with the dumbbell to the outside of the right hip, yes? You're going to take it up to the left arm, around, and over to the opposite hip. Up and over. All right. Step out to the side. Come up. Step out. Back to center and loop it. So the dumbbell is coming to the outside of the foot that's stepping out. There we go. So a side lunge with a L loop, shoulders, core oblique, lower body. Perfect. Lengthen the arms in front of you. Keep the shoulders drawn down. Side to side. Awesome. If you get confused, just keep doing the legs. Or go back and just do the upper body. Right? There we go. Right. Awesome. Elevating the heart rate. 1 minute. Low, a little quicker, but still in control. Nice. Now, if you're feeling your shoulders, guys, you got the right weight. Coming in, last 30 seconds. Good. Twenty seconds. Excellent. On that side lunge, toes, knees, hips, facing straight forward. One more each side. Up. And perfect. Good. Okay. So, come down. Grab the bench or chair works as well, just as long as it's not a really high chair. So I'm going to actually take the towel, give a little bit of support, okay? You're going to come down onto your elbow. Now, both feet are actually going to be on the bench. The more of the foot that you actually put on the bench, the easier it is, okay? So if you need to, you can come all the way down and almost put your knee on the bench. That's a little bit easier. So this is level one. Okay. Level two, you lift the leg and dip and hip. Yes, or just hold. Keep in mind, you're going to feel your obliques, but you're going to also feel in and outer thighs. And if it's too easy, I want you to adjust the leg that's on the bench. Both feet are stacked. Yes or yes? All right, guys, here we go. Three, two, and one. Either hold. Hip stack, lift, or just hold. Both legs are locked out. You can float the top leg off. Abs in tight, breathe. If you need to, take a break between 30 seconds, guys. So if you notice, I'm not doing any lift, I'm just holding. Lift up out of the shoulder. Flat as a board. You have a glass in front of you, glass behind you. You know, I like to say a toast in a toaster. Five, four, three, two, and gently come on down. Perfect. Okay, so we're going to switch to the opposite side. Take my bench over. So remember, your bottom leg is the leg that is doing the work. It's supported on the bench. Are we ready? Opposite side. Going in three, two, and one. Up and hold. Lift. Work. Take that top leg and just hold it. Lift it. Slide, slide, step inside. Remember, the more foot or leg that you have on that bench, couch, whatever you're using, cooler, the easier it is. Breathe. 30 seconds. Come on, Kurt. Keep pulling the abs in tight. You got it, guys. 15 seconds. How strong are you on this side? Five, four, three, two, and one. Excellent. Okay, perfect. Now we're gonna go right up into a Bulgarian split squat. Your option, two dumbbells or one. I'm gonna grab two. You can use a lower bench if you have it, but I want you to keep your shoulders stacked. John, if you need to at any time, drop those weights. Your front leg is out far enough that when you go straight down, the knee stays over the ankle and straight back up, never unloading. Okay, this is unloading. And you want to try to avoid the knee going way past the toe. Okay, so shoulders are stacked. I like to take my foot off to the side. given a wide center of gravity. I'm not leaning forward. This is quadriceps. Here we go. Three, you're going to hinge forward. So then you're going to shorten your range or take the weight off. Are we ready? Opposite side. Here we go. Down. Look down at that knee hamstring. But notice you're still feeling the ball of the foot push into the floor as well. Nice job, guys. Come on, come on, bring me down lower. Less than 15. Oh, feel me, baby. Last one. And perfect. All right, so you're gonna need one dumbbell. We're gonna do a little bit of core. And you're going to set the dumbbell upright. As so, you can come back on your elbows or lay all the way down, or you can come up into this position. So the feet are extended, you're just going side to side, up and over the dumbbell. Now, depending on your strength, try each of them slow and controlled. Try to avoid using your hip flexors, whether you lay all the way down or you come up. See which one. Not gonna tell you what's easiest or what's hardest. I want you to find something challenging for you. Ready? Feet together, let's go. Breathe through it. Do the humpy hump. So you've tried one version, try another. I just came up on my elbows. I just came up on my hands. Now my palms are flat on the floor. Still lifting. There we go. Ooh, what about no arms, just the legs? Come on, Sandy. Right? More core. You decide. Coming in, last 15 seconds. Oh yeah. If you're feeling your hip flexors, guys, let your knees go wide. So up and over. Three, two, nice. Okay, so you remember in the beginning, we actually did the legs on top. So what I want you to think about doing, this is where it gets tricky if you don't have a bench or something you can slide your feet through. If you don't, you're just using a couch, you're gonna bend the bottom leg. Otherwise, I'm gonna slide mine underneath and I'm gonna put the top leg again on the bench. Now my bottom leg, if I can help it, is gonna lift off the floor as well. So I'm on my elbow, I'm gonna go right into a side oblique and I'm just gonna hold or I'm gonna dip. Now when you dip, avoid your hips rocking forward or back. Keep them back. Yes or yes? Once again, the more leg that you have on the bench, the easier it is. If it's just your foot on the bench, that's gonna be extremely hard. So I want you to draw energy from your hips all the way through your legs as well. So keep them locked out. 60 seconds with this one. Are we ready? Yes we are, let's go. The bottom leg could be here. If you have to, you can set it on the floor, but then lift, right? Line through. Yes, is this a little tougher? Yes, it is. Challenge yourself. If you need to take a break, set it down, and then go right back up. Bottom elbow, pushing into the ground, shoulder away from the ears, less than 30 seconds. You can rest the bottom leg on the floor if you need to. And then lift it back up. Breathe. Like it, guys. Come on, come on. Less than 15 seconds. Lift that hip. Lift, 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 lift. Give me five, four, three, two. I see that arm, John. And relax down. Nice. So did you feel more? Oblique? Inner thigh or outer thigh? Remember, in the beginning, we put both legs on top and we lifted the top leg. This one, top leg only on the bench or couch, bottom leg is hovering. Are we ready? Three, two, opposite side, and up to daisy. Let's go. Remember, modified, push the knee down. Okay, today, if you're not feeling as strong, start somewhere, challenge yourself, lift the knee, and set it down if you have to. All I want to do is just zoom, zoom, zoom. Nice, guys. Got it. Going in the chest on the other side. Less than 30. Breathe. Cinch the belly button in through the spine. Come on, come on, cut team. You got it. Five, four, three, two, and one. Awesome. All right, get some water, guys. Grab your set of weights for a chest press. All I want to do is just zoom, zoom, zoom. Shake the butt. Okay, chest press. Are we ready? Okay, so your options on the chest press are one, feet flat on the floor. Two, give me that little bridge with your heels. You can also do this on a ball on the bench. With a bridge, holding the bridge while you give me chest press. Yes or yes? Pick your poison. Going in three, two, inhale, exhale. Press the weights together. Tap the elbows to the floor. Now, if you're doing the bridge, you're just holding the butt off of the floor. If your bench is farther away from your butt, or sliding like mine, it's gonna be more hamstring. If your heels are closer to the butt and the bench is closer, then you're gonna be using more glutes. Both work. Or if your feet are flat on the floor, you have heavy dumbbells and you're just focused on that chest. I like it. Come on. Good, guys, less than 20 seconds. Come on, come on, we got it. Five, four, three, two, last one. Excellent, so good. All right, we're gonna flip over. We're gonna go right into a dumbbell row. For those of you who do not like your hands on the floor, you can use a dumbbell to give yourself a little bit of height. So level one, knees in line with the hips, palms in line with the shoulders. You have that dumbbell and you're just gonna row. Single side, 1 minute. If you want to, you can take the opposite leg extended, keep both hips to the floor and row. Level two. Level three is a renegade row, but just single side without letting your hips lift. Okay, so I'd rather you, we haven't really focused too much on a strong back, so I'd rather you actually have a heavier weight, sandy, like a 25, definitely, and keep all fours down and really get the elbow. If you're doing a renegade, but your elbow is only coming to right here instead of higher, then I want you to actually go down to where you're on all fours. Are we ready? 1 minute, one side. In three, two, let's go. Don't stop, get it. At the top of that row. hold it for a hot second. You can do it with your back into it. I can do it with your back into it. You have a flat back either way. Hips are facing. Same direction. Good, 30 seconds. Nice, look at the floor today. You got it. Think of really pushing your chest to the floor, lengthening through your spine. Feel that back working. Nice. 10 seconds. Last one. And great job. All right, we're going right into the other side, guys. Are we ready? No break. 3, 2, and go. Yes. Remember, feel your core tightening. Feel the spine lengthening all the way through the tailbone. Gaze is straight down. 30 seconds. How high is that elbow going to the ceiling? Drive it through. Should be getting kind of heavy. You have the right weight, right? You got it. Less than 10 seconds. Come on, come on. Woohoo! Three, two, and excellent. Okay, guys, we're flipping back over. You're gonna actually do a chest fly. Yes, we're incorporating both chests. So feel free again to lift your butt and hold in the bridge. Chest flies are what? When your dumbbells are facing each other. Here we go, soften the elbows. Feet are up on the bench or on the floor. Three, two, give me a half hug. Squeeze back center. Make sure your elbows are touching the floor out to the side and that they're not higher than your shoulders. The elbows are pointed slightly towards the side, down, facing towards your hips. Now, if your feet are flat on the floor, I want you to squeeze your scapula blades together into the floor. Feel your lower back come off of the floor. Tap the dumbbells at the top. Nice. Sure, your chest definitely should be fatiguing right now. Come on, stay with me. 15 seconds. That's your motto. That's your words in your head. I've got the power. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Excellent. Okay, we're coming up. Deadlift right into a supine row. So, same weight. What is supine? Your palms are facing away from your body. You're going to give me a deadlift. So, your feet are hip width apart. Your row is hinging over. Row. Release, straight back up. Yes or yes? Here we go. 3, 2, soften your knees. Hips go back, chest goes forward. Elbows drive to the ceiling. Release down, squeeze the butt cheeks. Back up. Now, how low you go depends on you keeping your back flat. So I can go right there. Pull, right? As soon as I start to do this, I have to stop and correct it. Flat back, always. Look at the floor. Squeeze out. That's what we're working for, brick house. Remember, on your deadlift, what starts? Knees bent, hips, chest. Good. Less than 30. Try to avoid stretching your chin. Bring your chin towards your chest so that you have that neutral neck position. Good. Less than 15 seconds. You got it. One more, team. Hinge, row, and release. All right, get some water, guys. We are going on the floor with a crunch with a hammer curl. A little bit of bicep. Which ones do we want to do? Okay. We'll get a drink here. So, on the floor, your knees are going to stay bent. You're not going to curl until you come up. Okay, yeah? So it looks like this. Your weights are here. Yeah? You inhale, exhale, you come up. Tap the floor, straight back up. And then lower down. So you're holding this hammer curl in the position. Now, the farther you come up, remember, you're not rounded. You're lengthening through the back. Tap the floor. Straight back up, elbows are still pointing to the floor. Take your time on the way down. If you need to support your neck, support the neck down. Inhale, exhale, curl up, grab your weights, hammer curl, and then lower them back down. Choose your poison, here we go. Crunching. Tap, straight back up. So when you curl down, weight up by the shoulder. Now depending on where you're hanging onto the weight, that will determine your length and your range of motion. If you have a really long forearm, you're probably not gonna give me a big bicep curl, but usually that's too many people. Feel free to lengthen the legs a little bit more. Or hold the bend. Nice. 30 seconds.
Clap your hands, everybody, if you've got what it takes. Because I'm Curtis Blow, and I want you to know that these are the breaks. Clap your hands, everybody, if you've got what it takes. Because I'm Curtis Blow, and I want you to know that these are the breaks.
You got it. One more. Down and up. Excellent. Okay, guys, we're coming up. We're going to do a lateral raise. I want you to actually try to give me a lighter dumbbell. You're going to reverse lunge, okay? The same side that goes back is going to be the same side, so you're actually going to give me a lateral raise. Alternating, right? Now look, I'm hovering low, and then I raise, and then I come straight back up. Let me switch these weights for a second. All right. So, keep it slow and controlled. This is for 2 minutes. This is the medial part of the shoulder. I want you keeping your thumb to the ceiling. I want to see your arms extended out. When you fatigue, the arms come in closer. Lift from the elbow. Are we ready? Right leg goes back first. Right reverse lunge, hold, right arm, lateral raise, foot. Now, if it's too much to do it here, then come back up and raise. But if you're giving me the lateral raise while you're holding, it's a lot more oblique and forward. All right. Look out at your hands. The thumb is still slightly to the ceiling. Good. Think about where you're feeling it. The perfect opportunity to really get the hip and the quadricep. The hip to open up, the quadricep to not be as tight around that knee. Active stretch. What's happening, John? Come on. I know it's harder. 1 minute to go. Break it up, break it up, break it up. What is something else we can do? Reverse lunge down all the way. Come up. Knee goes all the way to the floor. If you're fatiguing, try it. Right?
To the guy in blue, what you gonna do?
Nice.
And to the girl in green, don't be so mean.
Four. Stay with what we were doing. Hover. Notice there's no movement through the body when that arm raises up. Silence the body. Guys, you only got 15 seconds. Yes. Ow! One more. Left side. And nice job! Great. Tricep. Two things, and you're finished, guys. Are you ready for the tricep? Grab the two dumbbells. You got it. Remember, weights, when they go together for the overhead tricep extension, only push them together when you're fatigued. Only go to one weight when you're fatigued. You do want to make sure you lock out the elbows at the top. You want to make sure that your elbows are not moving through the motion. What do I mean by that? I'm here. So when I bring the forearm down, I'm not allowing my elbows to go back. I'm keeping them pressed against the bench that is right on my elbows resting on. Yes or yes? So we are going all the way down, all the way at the top without flicking your wrist. Are we ready? Three, two, and one. Now, if you want the dumbbells to face each other, that works. If you want the palms to face your knees, that works as well. It's a personal preference. Once you've got the motion, I want you to draw your shoulder blades down. Come on. Good. You got it, guys. So, notice your shoulders. They're not creeping up next to your ears. If your feet are flat on the floor, your lower back is not on the floor. Come on. Less than 10. 5, 4, 3, 2. Push the weights together, rest them on your chest. So you have a crush press, and this is still included in part of this tricep section, and then we have one more tricep kickback as we come up, and then you'll be done. So the weight, each time, try to go as low as you can. Elbows try to touch the floor right next to each side of the rib cage. Are we ready? 3, 2, push the weights together, actively using the chest, press them to the ceiling and towards your knees. So you're definitely not pressing the weights towards your head. Push them out towards your knees and to the ceiling. A little bit of an angle, or at least straight up. So my elbows are actually touching the floor towards my hips. Push, lock, press. Are you still working the chest? Yes, you are. Good. And inhale down. Exhale, press away. Nice, guys. Show me, show me, show me. I'm from Missouri. I like it. Less than 30 seconds. You can always go to one dumbbell versus just stopping. That fight or a flight, you want to fight. Come on, you got it. Give me 5, 4, 3, 2, And one, perfect. Okay, so one dumbbell, flip on over. I'm gonna do this kneeling. You can also do one foot on the bench, hinging over. Elbow is high to the ceiling, straight back, kick back. Shoulder stays down. Look where my cock, this is the cock and that's the load, right? So it's right here, and then press it back. You wanna avoid coming up to here because that's just a rest. So think of drawing a gun out of the holster and lock. Yes? Here we go. Three, shoulder stays on the floor. Two, and one. Straight back. Now, if you're a little fatigued through your triceps, your elbow won't be as high to the ceiling. Straight back. Notice you're not flicking your wrist. And then hold it back there for that hot second. Down and hold. Draw the shoulders away from the ears. Think of lengthening through the spine. You're still keeping your core nice and tight. Awesome. You guys look so good. Oh, my BGs. Are you getting down by the way I move? You changed the words. Did you hear that? Yes. Come on. Come on. You got it. Five, four, three, two, and one. Nice work, guys. Hey, flip it over to the opposite side. So, did a little bit different stuff today for your shoulders. Working the whole body, a lot more inner and outer side. Elbow is high to the ceiling. Here we go, opposite side. Now, lean into that leg if you're kneeling. And get a little bit of an angle. And you can really push that elbow higher to the ceiling and hold it there. Press back. I'm still looking for a good plaster person. If you notice, my sheetrock behind me is up but not plastered. I guess I'm going to have to try to attack that. Having a little bit of issue getting people who are good. Most of the people who actually are good are booked out for months. It's good, guys. Coming into the last 20 seconds. We'll cool you down. We'll stretch you out. The most important part of your ritual. Five. Four. Three, two, last one, and perfect. Okay, keep that knee down. Lift the chest, take the foot out a little bit wider. Reach behind, see if you can grab that leg without the hip turning, and just hold. If your hip starts to externally rotate, then release the foot or use a strap, a yoga strap, or a towel. Now, if you have it all the way up and the heel is touching the booty like mine, squeeze your butt cheek and push forward. You see how I just drove my hip forward? But my chest didn't go forward. My chest, and I leaned back a little bit. So now I'm feeling the stretch a little bit more on the outside. Nice work today, guys. Holding that stretch, 10 seconds. Makes you want to dance, doesn't it, Kurt? And release. Go ahead and flip it around. Opposite side. Grab that foot. Hold the stretch. If you're really tight, just release it. Squeeze the butt cheek, and you'll be in this position, depending on where you're tight at. Hey. I understand Cool in the Gang, guys, is playing at the Hollywood this weekend. I could have swore I saw them, not last year, but maybe 3 years ago, probably now. Oh my God, time. At the fair, actually. I think they were playing at the fair. I thought they were good. Good, and release that leg. Come on up. Take your feet hip width apart, clasp the hands behind, roll the shoulders back, and just press them away. Feel the stretch through the shoulders, through the triceps, through the chest. Knees are bent. Good. Take your hands onto your quadriceps. Push your hips back. You're trying to lift your tailbone, so this is all hamstring stretch. Chest push down to the floor. I'm kind of lifting the tailbone up and at the same time pressing it away. Come on up, let's stretch the hamstring. We're still gonna get the inner thighs. We'll actually take your feet nice and wide. Good, switch to the opposite tricep. Now the key with this, with the inner thigh stretch, is trying to keep your feet flat on the floor, so both feet stay flat. Release it down, come on down. Now, I can go all the way down, but if you see, my feet are still flat on the floor. Try to avoid lifting that toe at first. If it's too much on your ankle, then go ahead and lift the toe. Okay. And I should really get that inner thigh stretch on one side. Kind of looks like I'm resting my butt on the floor, but I'm not. Everybody over here, everybody over there. Move. Yes, good. And go to the opposite side. You can also do the frog stretch if that feels better for you. Good. Come on up. Keep those feet wide. Take your hands down to the floor. If you can't touch the hands to the floor, take it wider. Draw the belly button in. Bend your knees and push your hips back. So from the side, I'm here. Again, hamstring stretch, flat back. And lengthen. And bend. Lengthen. And if you need to, bend your knees, but bring the toes, heels all the way back to center. Lengthening, coming all the way up, stacking one vertebrae at a time. Coming up center, big inhale. Hands together, down to heart center.